When everyone's on the same page, getting things done at work is easy. No matter what you do or what industry you're in, how you communicate is key. Everything you type is equally important to collaboration, and Grammarly can help. Think of it as your AI writing partner, empowering you to communicate effectively and efficiently so you can make a bigger impact in the workplace. 96% of Grammarly users say it helps them craft more impactful writing. And as the gold standard of responsible AI, Grammarly is your secure AI writing partner that allows your team to make their point and move faster. By understanding your writing and context, Grammarly provides relevant, personalized suggestions. And with tone suggestions, you can navigate even the most difficult work conversations. You can also save time from spending hours editing drafts to just seconds with one click. Sign up and download Grammarly for free at grammarly.com/podcast. That's grammarly.com/podcast. Easier said, done.
Welcome to the Phil Paleologi Show, with updates and breaking news from the WBSM newsroom and on the WBSM app. And your calls and conversation at 508-996-0500. Here he is, New Bedford's number one talk show host, WBSM's morning mayor, Phil Paleologus.
We're going to have a good time today. Absolutely. 8 minutes after 6 o'clock. Are you ready to dance? Kate and I welcoming you in and getting excited for a brand new year. And this question, in my opinion, I think far, far too many Americans prefer opinions that validate their own beliefs rather than seeking knowledge from somebody who disagrees and perhaps has a different perspective. What about you? Are you one of them? Nice to have you with us. We have a Wednesday, the 28th of December. Thank you so much for waking up with the morning mayor. Today starts a milder change, and when you step outside, yeah, it's cold, but it's not that biting cold, you know, that the wind produces. We will have sunshine. It may start out as a milky sunshine, meaning it's filtered behind the clouds, so we're not going to have a bright day like yesterday, but we will have sun, and it's going to warm up, folks. Oh, yeah, the tropical 40s. Are you kidding me? Where's my bikini? We'll keep an eye out for the New Year's Eve celebrations. All right. I don't know yet. We haven't heard about any cancellations, so we will be sure to pass that along as soon as we get any kind of information, all right? The numbers, what numbers? The numbers, Mega Millions, were drawn last night. No winner. So here we go again. The Tuesday night drawing was for $565 million in Mega Millions jackpot, and the winning numbers. You have a ticket there? Check these numbers. You might have hit some money anyway. 9, 13, 36, 59, and 61 with a mega ball of 11 and a mega plier 3 times. All right? So here we go. See you Friday for another chance to win. Well, I'm sure it's going to jump up past $600 million now, right? Absolutely. Did you hear that Ames Department Store is going to make a return? That will bring back some old memories, huh? We also are keeping our sights on Southwest Airlines. They are canceling more flights today. They really have received the worst publicity possible during the busiest time, and I'm sure this is going to have a very unpleasant impact on that company. Just as a side note, when folks would come into the Shamit Diner and wouldn't be happy with the meal, you know, called me over and said, "Hey, you know what? This liver tastes like shoes." Well, I always tried to tamp it down a little, and then I'd walk over with a nice gift certificate for $50. And I said, will this help make up for our mistake, please? And before you know it, we were laughing and everything was fine. So we will see whether that is the case with Southwest Airlines having canceled more flights. The luggage, dear God, what are they going to, how are they going to really pass around that one issue that has been a problem, and that is leftover luggage from the flights. And it's that way because the airlines would not allow the passengers to get their own luggage. And so some of it is out there, some of it is over here, and it is a mess, a real mess. So we'll keep an eye on that. And the reason I brought up the shoe leather liver is because Southwest Air better come up with some nice little benefits for those who were impacted.
Take the Morning Mayor wherever you go. Download the WBSM app.
I don't mind going around the world. No. let's see. We have the Pats. They are in Foxborough this weekend. That's an interesting story for 2022. And on Friday, Trump's taxes will go public. And the Celtics, they went public. 126 to 102 past the Rockets. Loved it. And also, I was mentioning the numbers. Did you get them? Can I repeat? Can I repeat the number? Yeah, of course. The numbers for this is the Mega Millions jackpot were 9, 13, 36, 59, and 61 with a Mega Ball of 11. And the Mega Plier is 3 times. All right. So that's that. However, did you hear? We've got ourselves a brand new instant ticket. Hold on, hold on. It is now going to cost you, if you want to play that game, $50. $50, a scratch ticket, starting on February the 7th.
Take the Morning Mayor wherever you go. Download the WBSM app.
Would you buy a scratch ticket for $50?
The Morning Mayor.
Chris is asking me, what did I ask at the very beginning of the show about people you disagree with? I love it. No, I was asking if you agree that too many of us, and most especially younger people, but too many of us prefer opinions that actually support your point of view, you know, your beliefs. We prefer opinions with similar beliefs rather than actively seeking out knowledge. Now, what do you mean by knowledge? Well, remember Socrates said the wise man loves to be corrected, right? Is that still true?
Take the Morning Mayor wherever you go. Download the WBSM app.
No wonder Celeste never liked Socrates. 618, just joking. Great to have you with us. And it is a weird story. But education is indispensable, no doubt about it. And constructive citizenship. You think we're getting that at the border, my friends? Constructive citizenship. Have you ever heard of it? Good, because I just implemented those words as a defense against destructive ideologies. Ideologies that I fear, like socialism and its first cousins. So I'm just throwing out, you know, all of these thoughts at the end of the year. If do you hang around folks who more or less, you know, support or validate your beliefs and you go along hunky-dory? What a mess. With thousands, when I say thousands, folks, I mean hundreds of thousands bags of luggage piled up at this airport, that airport over there. Some of the luggage was already shipped out, but the passengers are at Logan. So their luggage may be out in Detroit or someplace. But the luggage was also piling up throughout Chicago's Midway International Airport Monday. They said that that place was a mess as hundreds of flights were canceled or delayed because of the winter storm. Early indications say, well, it's an act of God and we can't do much about it. Well, you think Southwest Air is going to do well with that response? I don't either. Anyway, more than half of the flights at that airport, at least Midway, found it very, very difficult to retrieve their luggage. Travelers said that they have not been given enough information to locate their bags. Here's one passenger. At first, we were told that our bags would be down here. So, we went, we searched. My bag is kind of distinctive, and I don't see it anywhere. What do you think, folks? Any comments from you?
1420 WBSM is now also on 99.5 FM.
It is with sadness, it's a very, very sad day because a lot of our friends, if you've noticed, in 2022 are passing away. And it's with sadness and sympathy that I inform you of the passing of local attorney Robert X. Farris. Now, Bob was the father to Stella. And Paiva and Susan and Michael and had a brother, is the brother of Jenny Constantakos, actually. And believe me when I tell you, we're a small Orthodox community and our thoughts and our prayers surround everybody at the passing of Robert X. Farris. May his memory be eternal.
New Bedford's News Talk Station, 1420 WBSM. This is the voice of New Bedford.
622, you doing all right? Okay, here we go. Whenever the new year comes around, news media always takes a look at, well, here are the top stories of 2022. You know, and then they read pages of boring stuff. Anyway. Here's my contribution to that question, all right? Whether the tight labor market is going to continue in 2023 and why. You know, I'm searching through a lot of stories that suggest that the answer is yes. It's the labor force that vanished, right? The combination of those who were working, who were making a living, and then all this COVID stuff. So there are a lot of contributing factors to this, but we will have to wait and see what 2023 brings us. But I'm very concerned about the labor market and where the hell did those workers go to?
A message from the National Police Association. It used to be that any able-bodied person would offer to assist a police officer in danger. Now, passers-by are more likely to take a video. There's a better use for your phone when an officer's in trouble. Call 911. Tell the operator where you are and what you see. Then, start your video to provide evidence later. To learn more about how you can assist law enforcement, visit nationalpolice.org. That's nationalpolice.org.
If a natural disaster comes knocking, how prepared is your family? You can't just close the door on earthquakes, floods, or hurricanes and hope they go away. That's why it's important to make a plan now. Ready.gov/plan has the tools and tips you need to prepare your family for an emergency. So if disaster shows up at your doorstep, you'll be ready. Visit ready.gov/plan and make a plan today. Brought to you by FEMA and the Ad Council.
Get breaking news alerts, stream audio, send us text messages,
and get live traffic and weather updates all on the WBSM app. Download it now from your app store or at WBSM.com.
I love being with you every morning because I get a chance to connect with you and tell you some of the stories that perhaps we'll be talking about, or at least find out about some of the events. I was just mentioning the passing of local attorney Robert X. Farris, and in the next town over, many of you don't have to come from Fall River, but the former police commissioner and a great, I don't know if he went pro, but a great boxer. He was the founder. Have you ever heard of PAL, P-A-L, and that's not short for Paleologus, no? Nero Farris. He passed away at the age of 92, having lived a full life and giving a lot of his life to help others, to make others happy. That brought him joy. And Nero died suddenly at Charlton Memorial on Saturday. He was an icon in the Fall River community, and we, in sympathy, embrace his family, his friends, his relatives, but mostly the work that he did. We need people to come in and take the place of others, and that's going to be a real problem because, as I see it, a lot of the folks have changed since COVID, right? Absolutely. I didn't say they were lazy. No, they're just not working.
Back to the Morning Mayor, Phil Paleologus on 1420 WBSM, New Bedford's News Talk Station.
Let me share with you a little bit of wisdom. After many, many decades having a diner, a lazy country is sure to find its real cancerous problems, meaning, when I say cancerous, I mean in the symbolic sense. If our country goes lazy, we're probably going to be looking at another country to take the place of number one. Florida Governor Ron DeSantis petitioned the state Supreme Court earlier this month for an ordeal to impanel a statewide grand jury probe of any wrongdoing that was related to COVID-19 vaccines. The court gave DeSantis the green light on Thursday. This has a number of health officials really PO'd and worried. And you know what, folks? We have 50 states. If you don't like it down there in Florida, move. This has a number of health officials all over. They're complaining. They said that there wasn't a truth-finding mission behind this or anything like that. Well, apparently there was, because a number of judges agreed with DeSantis. Good morning. It's 6:27. It's a pleasure to be with you.
Our workforce needs work. I'm Holly Robinson Pete. Many of you might not know this, but my 22-year-old son has autism.
So do I. My name is Kevin Valdez, and my intellectual difference makes me the passionate actor that I am.
And I'm Mackenzie Cohen, a Paralympian with a developmental difference. Did you know that 97% of HR professionals say that employees with disabilities perform the same or better than their peers without disabilities? Yet still, the differently abled face so many employment challenges in this country.
It is time we start building a workforce that works for all. A workforce that is diverse, inclusive, and equitable for those with intellectual differences.
And for those with developmental differences, too.
A workforce that recognizes that our greatest strengths lie in our differences.
It is time we hire inclusively.
Join us, Delivering Jobs and the SHRM Foundation, in creating pathways to 1 million jobs and leadership opportunities. Please visit deliveringjobs.org.
Take the Morning Mayor wherever you go. Download the WBSM app.
So let me put this in order for you. Good morning. I love you. Thanks for tuning in. And Nantucket liquor stores are bracing for the coming nip bottle ban. Yeah, they no more nips over there, construction people. Liquor stores on Nantucket are scrambling to sell off all of their supplies of single-serving alcohol bottles, you know, the nips, as the ban on these tiny little bottles was approved at last year's town meeting, and it takes effect. There's no grace period. On January the 1st, I don't know whether that's the same day the bras fall off, but current reports say that no grace period this year, and that distributors have informed the stores that they are unable to take back any unsold nips. So there's a new story for you. Good morning. Great to have you with us. Thank you for these cards. Thank you very, very much. Appreciate it. And the your messages are awesome. Thank you. They're authentic and from your heart. Thank you so very, very much. The gentleman, somebody wants me to repeat, in Fall River is Nero Farias. He was 92. Nero, N-E-R-O, Nero Farias. Perhaps you heard of his name. Many, many years. A mentor to kids in Fall River. That's what we need. I have mentors. And I'm very, very happy that the mentors that I chose, none of them agree with me in most areas. So there.
If a natural disaster comes knocking, how prepared is your family? You can't just close the door on earthquakes, floods, or hurricanes and hope they go away. That's why it's important to make a plan now. Ready.gov/plan has the tools and tips you need to prepare your family for an emergency. So if disaster shows up at your doorstep, you'll be ready. Visit ready.gov/plan and make a plan today. Brought to you by FEMA and the Ad Council.
All right, let's say I have a diner on the corner and all of a sudden three more diners decide to occupy that same area. What's the first thing I do?
Pancakes.
What?
make pancakes.
I love it.
What else are you supposed to do? Food.
Good morning, Kate.
Good morning.
What you got?
A severe winter storm that's pummeled parts of the U.S. in recent days is now blamed for more than 60 deaths. Around half of those have been in New York, where snowfall in Buffalo reached 100 inches on Tuesday. The weather is also disrupting travel, with thousands of canceled and delayed flights. French authorities are investigating as suicide the drowning of an Iranian man in the southeastern city of Lyon. 38-year-old Mohamed Mouradi had posted on social media about killing himself to draw attention to the protest crackdown in Iran. Mouradi was found in the river Rhone late on Monday. Emergency services intervened but were unable to resuscitate him on the riverbank. He apparently did it to highlight protests in Iran against the treatment of women since the death in custody of 22-year-old Mahsa Amini. Benjamin Netanyahu's incoming hardline government has put West Bank settlement expansion at the top of its list of priorities, a day before it's set to be sworn into office. Netanyahu's Likud party released the new government's policy guidelines on Wednesday, the first of which is that it will, quote, advance and develop settlement in all parts of the land of Israel, in the Galilee, Negev, Golan Heights, and Judea and Samaria, the biblical names for the West Bank. Southwest Airlines CEO Bob Jordan is apologizing after thousands of canceled flights left angry travelers stranded or scrambling again on Tuesday. Jordan said he's truly sorry and that there's a massive effort to stabilize the airline and get things back to normal. Winter storms and huge operational challenges sent Southwest into a meltdown. Meanwhile, travel headaches continue at the nation's airports, with more than 2,700 flights already canceled this morning, according to FlightAware.com. And as has been the case for several days now, hundreds more are delayed. Traveler Sharon Taylor says she flew on Southwest to visit family in Denver, but hasn't seen her bag for 5 days since landing.
I love Southwest. I've been to Hawaii on it. That's my choice of airlines. But right now, I'm frustrated. I haven't combed my hair since Friday. I've worn this since Friday. I've washed it out every day.
Southwest is responsible for the vast majority of the cancellations again today. The company is desperately trying to return to normal operations after weather and operational issues crippled the airline as people scramble to get back home from the holiday weekend. A Trump-era policy known as Title 42 that allows border officials to turn away asylum seekers for public health concerns remains in place for now, after Tuesday's ruling from the Supreme Court. While a final ruling isn't expected until next year, President Biden had this to say yesterday.
And in the meantime, we have to enforce it, but I think it's overdue.
The High Court voted 5-4 to grant an emergency request from 19 Republican state attorneys general. Justices will decide in the coming months whether the states should be allowed to intervene in the defense of the policy. Former President Trump's tax returns will be released later this week. Reports say the House Ways and Means Committee will release a redacted version of Trump's tax returns Friday morning. The House panel last week voted to release 6 years of Trump's tax documents. House Democrats gained access to the records earlier this month as part of an investigation into whether the IRS audit of the former president was conducted properly. One of the men who conspired to kidnap Michigan Governor Gretchen Whitmer is being sentenced to 16 years in prison. Adam Fox was convicted in August in a 2020 plot to abduct the Democratic governor over her COVID-19 restrictions. A judge opted against the prosecution's bid to put Fox behind bars for life. Scientists have developed a blood test to diagnose Alzheimer's disease. If validated, the test could allow faster diagnosis and earlier therapies to treat the most common form of dementia. Current diagnosis methods are expensive brain imaging or a painful lumbar puncture, drawing a sample of cerebrospinal fluid from the lower back. Pope Francis is asking for prayers for former Pope Benedict XVI, saying his predecessor is, quote, very sick. Francis made the surprise appeal today at the end of his general audience. The 95-year-old Benedict resigned in 2013, becoming the first pope in about 600 years to step down. In sports, the Celtics blew past the Rockets in a 126-102 victory in Boston. The Seas improved to an NBA best 25-10 and are back in action tomorrow night when the Clippers come to town. But the Bruins fell to the Senators in Ottawa in shootouts. Boston is still the best team in the league with 57 points. Now for a look at your local forecast from ABC 6.
As you head out the door this morning, grab the winter gear. Temperatures rising through the 20s and 30s will top off near 40 with a blend of sun and clouds. It will be breezy this afternoon. For overnight tonight, temperature near 32. And then we are near 45 with sun and clouds on your Thursday. And we bump it up to 50 on Friday. From the ABC 6 Weather Center, I'm Storm Tracker Meteorologist Nick Morganelli on New Bedford's News Talk Station, 1420 WBSM.
At the moment, it is 26 degrees and mostly cloudy. I'm Kate Robinson for WBSM News. Stay up to date with New Bedford's News Talk Station, 1420 WBSM, and get breaking news alerts and podcasts with the WBSM app.
Is a brief message from Southwest.
I'm sorry, so sorry that I was such a fool. I didn't know love could be so cruel.
Take the Morning Mayor wherever you go. Download the WBSM app. Howie Carr.
Welcome back. Are you willing to shell out $50 for a scratch ticket? Well, They're coming out with it in February, a $50 scratch ticket. There you go. And I hear that Ames is coming back. I remember Ames when I was a kid, and my yaya would take me to Ames in Salem because she lived in Peabody. Speaking of businesses, I hope Stephanie, the star of Joe's Tire, is listening. She's a queen. Stephanie, you're the best. Let me turn this around. How many of you are driving around without a spare tire?
The United States has the highest rate of incarceration in the world. At the Equal Justice Initiative, we believe mass incarceration has to end. There is this presumption of dangerousness and guilt that gets assigned to black and brown people. We have to confront our history of racial injustice and commit to a new era of truth. There's something better waiting for us, something that feels more like freedom. Truth can inspire change. Please learn more at EJI.org.
Good morning. Welcome. 6:44. We have a historic flight fiasco. It's incredible. Sky-high frustration, no doubt about it. Kate was telling you about what happened with ruling Title 42. It, for now, can stay. And by the way, without Title 42, 18,000 immigrants cross daily. That is something, folks, that only Congress, not Biden, not anyone else, can fix. Only Congress can fix 18,000 per day, every day.
Imagine if information came with a nutrition label. Then you'd know if what you're consuming has the right mix of verified facts, credible sources, and relevant context. But news and information doesn't come with a label. It's on us to develop a healthy news diet ourselves. Let's all resolve to strengthen our news literacy so we can make healthier choices about what news and information to consume, share, and act on. Test your news literacy fitness with our quiz at newslit.org. Exercise your right to be well-informed and get news lit fit.
Would you like a nice bowl of soup? You like soup? I had a fabulous chicken noodle soup. But you know who made it? The cooks up there at Boston Medical. They were great. Anyway, we want to put a little bit of that kind of enjoyment, but not at the hospital, but of Portugal into a little Portuguese restaurant that is just getting so many rave reviews. I'm talking about Aliança. You can enjoy a little bit and a little bite of Portuguese seasoned steaks. They have fresh sea bass, chicken kebabs and garlic shrimp and grilled cod and caserla. And, boy, she does it all. And if you haven't tried Susie's chicken cognac, you're missing out on something. This is a perfect time to go. In fact, when you go there, buy a gift certificate. They always make great, great gifts and a wonderful place to socialize after dinner. In the same building right next door, they have a lot of fun in that bar. It's 6:46, and we have a lot more to talk about. First, I want to, when I come back, just get some more information on a murder that shocked all of us. This was the crime that really paralyzed us, 5 years ago. The sentencing of the mother who stabbed and killed her two little boys is this morning at 9 o'clock. She said that she went on the internet and followed the instructions that she found there. Unbelievable. But that's how Satan works.
Take the Morning Mayor wherever you go. Download the WBSM app.
Good morning. Nice of you to join us. We have thousands and thousands of bags piled up And airports, baggage claims, still there. Details straight ahead. The death toll from the historic winter storm has reached 60, as up to 9 more inches are expected. This is incredible what they're getting out there in the Buffalo area. And it seems Tom Brady is going to take his time in deciding when he wants to hang up his cleats again. I say again because he already announced, right? Or no. The Buccaneers, well, he was at the center of this retirement chapter earlier this year, right? And he was asked on Monday during a podcast. The podcast is Let's Go. If he's thought about calling it quits, calling it a career after speculation, of course, surrounding his future in the league continues. And he said, well, I think next time I decide to retire, that's it for me. So whenever that day comes, we'll figure it out. Tom Brady.
What I know about courage, I learned from my adoptive mom. She said sometimes you just gotta hold on and know we'll get through this.
Mom, we are so high up. Hold my hand.
No, you hold my hand.
Here we go.
Learn about adopting a teen from foster care. You can't imagine the reward. Visit AdoptUSKids.org to find out more. This message is brought to you by AdoptUSKids, the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, and the Ad Council.
So it's not cold, cold, even though the thermometer says it's in the 30s. There's little wind, so the cold doesn't go right to your bones. But we will have a bright day with filtered sunshine. It's Thursday night going into Friday. The weekend is a little bit spotty here, so we'll wait for the professionals to tell us which way these things are going, but hopefully it won't rain on our celebration parade, will it? I hope not. If you would like to know more about the, they're going to take down that smokestack downtown. If you had any questions about it, Old Bedford Village and Andrew Saunders of New Bedford Foss Marine Terminal, along with Angela Johnston of BCC, they're going to have a community meeting, and you're invited on Thursday, December 29th. All right. Today's the 28th. 4 o'clock to 7 o'clock, 4 in the afternoon to 7, and they're going to have, music, and it's going to be an event, but that's where you can get answers about the cleanup, because they were going to bring down that smokestack, but then folks went up to a buddy and said, hey, what happens if there's something really toxic inside that smokestack and it goes airborne? Have they thought about it? So he brought that to Mr. Saunders, Andrew Saunders, and they're working now on finding a way to do this properly. I commend them. That's a great move. We'll be right back.
Has your child swallowed your medicine, your laundry detergent, your nail polish remover? Call the Poison Helpline. Have you inhaled paint thinner, glue, pesticides? Call the Poison Helpline. Have a question about a dose?
If you want to hear everything,
the meeting I was referring to before the break, it's going to be held at the Cape Verdean Veterans Memorial Hall. Okay, the Cape Verdean Veterans Memorial Hall is the venue Thursday, tomorrow, 4 to 7. And you can get more information if you call Buddy Andrade, 774-202-0603. And that's for anyone who wants information about the smokestack coming down. Well, the city of Fall River has lost a favorite citizen, Nero Farias, 92, who was the originator of PAL and so many wonderful charities, has passed away. We also have some sad news to give you this morning. Robert Exafaris has also passed away. The attorney, Robert Exafaris, has passed away, and all of us at St. George Greek Orthodox Church extend our deepest, deepest sympathy.
Take the Morning Mayor wherever you go. Download the WBSM app.
For more than 75 years, the VA Home Loan Benefit has helped millions of eligible veterans and service members achieve their piece of the American dream, a home for their families. Did you know that you could purchase a home or refinance your current home loan with your VA Home Loan Benefit? VA Home Loans have lower closing costs and generally enjoy lower interest rates than other borrowers. The VA Home Loan may save you thousands of dollars on your mortgage. For more information, visit www.va.gov or talk to a lender of your choice. Choose VA.
Phil Paleologus. He's smart and he's got style like the all-new Ford Fusion. Take your test drive today at Wareham Ford, 1420 WBSM.
You know, when you're invited to a party and you know that most of the people there are folks that you like, that you're comfortable around, that's one thing. But if it's not that way, if there's a lot of folks who don't see things like you do, it could be a little frustrating, right? Well, we have, that comes down to trust and connection and friendship. We have a business here in New Bedford whose core is all about that. Joe O'Neill, Medicare Help 65. This company, Medicare Plans, he has it all for you. National carriers, zero monthly premiums. He has so much. In fact, he has a zero monthly premium over-the-counter product that benefits eyeglass allowance, gym memberships, preventative dental care, zero copay on generic medications. He does it all. And Celeste and I not only trust Joe O'Neill, he has our future in his hands as well. Yes, this is how much we trust him, and I pass along that advice to you. If you are at that age, Medicare Help 65 is the place to go, conveniently located on Rockdale Avenue, or you can give Joe a call. 774-526-0014, or you can visit his really nice, his new designed website at MedicareHelp65.com.
Take the Morning Mayor wherever you go. Download the WBSM app.
And good morning. We have a lot of news to share with you. No word yet about what's going to happen over the weekend. Of course, we all want no rain so that we can go on with our celebrations. But again, we'll have to wait and see what the pros say. In the meantime, you are lucky. There have been folks in airports around the country who today is what? Wednesday, who haven't changed their clothes since last Friday. Now, I think that's the perspective that I would go out on national TV and expound on. You see? That brings the point home.
Hey guys, time to get in on the action for the biggest moments in basketball with Prize Picks, America's number one fantasy sports app. Just select two or more players, pick more or less on their projections, place your entry, and win up to 100 times your money. Right now, Prize Picks will match your first deposit of up to $100. Just download the Prize Picks app and use the code GET100. That's code GET100 on Prize Picks for a first deposit match of up to $100. Prize Picks, pick more, pick less. It's that easy.